大家好，我是陈冠廷，目前在人人服务社工作，希望大家都平安。那我们今天要上的课是初级公民课第三周的问题，是第26题到第40题，入籍公民历史及政府问题。如果你还没加入我们的微信群的话呢，可以用这个二维码扫描并加入我们的微信群。那我们先从第26题开始看。26题，我们先念一次。We elect a president for how many years? We elect a president for how many years? How many years 就是多少年的意思。Elect 是选。所以，我们每多少年选一次总统？答案是 four。我们再把题目念一次：We elect a president for how many years? We elect a president for how many years? 答案是 four。Four，我们到下一题，第27题，一样，我们先念一次问题：In what month do we vote for president? In what month do we vote for president? Vote 是选的意思，是投票的意思。那意思是说，在哪一个月？In what month？我们去选总统？Do we vote for president？答案是11月，November。November。那我们再念一次：In what month do we vote for president？In what month？Do we vote for president? 答案是 November。November。第28题。What is the name of the president of the United States now? What is the name of the president of the United States now？那 United States 大家都知道是美国。President of the United States 就是美国的总统。这个 of 有点像是中文的的，这个用滑鼠写得很丑，像是中文的的。那它是反过来的。我们说美国的总统，他们说总统。Of 美国，那我们再念一次：What is the name of the president of the United States now？那你可以看到这里有另外一个 of，所以呢，我们说是总统的名字，那他们是说名字 of 总统，所以现在美国总统的姓名是什么？Donald Trump，Donald Trump，你也可以只说 Trump，Donald Trump。最后我们再念一次：What is the name of the president of the United States now？Donald Trump，Donald Trump。那我们到第29题。我们先念一次问题：What is the name of the vice president of the United States now？跟上一题很像，只是呢，他把这个 president 换成 vice president。vice president 就是副总统的意思。所以，现任美国的副总统的名字是什么 What is the name of the Vice President of the United States now? Mike Pence. Mike Pence. 也可以说 Pence 就好了。最后我们再念一次问题。What is the name of the Vice President of the United States now? Mike Pence. Mike Pence. 那我们到下一题。If the President can no longer serve, who becomes President? If the President can no longer serve, who becomes President? No longer 就是不能再做什么事情。那在这里呢 ,serve 是服务、履行职责的意思。所以 can no longer serve 就是不能继续履行职责。所以 if the president can no longer serve, who becomes president? Becomes 是变成的意思。那如果总统不能履行职责，谁会变成总统？ The vice president。The vice president 前面有提到他是副总统。The vice president。所以如果总统不能继续工作，副总统就会变成总统。最后我们再念一次。If the president can no longer serve, who becomes president? If the president can no longer serve, who becomes president? The vice president. The vice president. 那我们到下一题。第31题，一样我们先念一次问题。If both the president and the vice president can no longer serve, who becomes president? 跟上一题很像，只是它加了这个字 both。Both 是两个，两个都。那在这里两个是指总统跟副总统，所以如果总统和副总统两个都不能履行他的职责， who becomes president? 谁会变总统？答案是 the speaker of the house. The speaker of the house.那这一题我们再念一次。If both the president and the vice president can no longer serve, who becomes president? If both the president and the vice president can no longer serve, who becomes president?答案是 the speaker of the house. The speaker of the house. 那我们到下一题。第32题。Who is the commander in chief of the military? Who is the commander-in-chief of the military. 那 commander-in-chief 就是最高领导人的意思。那最高领导人的什么呢？ military。 所以 military 是军队， military 的最高领导人是谁？那我们这里 military 翻成的是三军，总共 是海军、陆军跟空军三军。三军统帅是谁？答案是 The President。The President， 总统是三军统帅。那我们再把这个问题念一次 ：Who is the commander in chief of the military？ Who is the commander in chief of the military？ The president。The president。那我们到下一题，第33题。Who signs bills to become laws? Who signs bills to become laws? Signs 是签署的意思， bills 是法案， become 是变成，那 laws 就是我们知道的法律。Who signs bills to become law? 是谁要签署这个法案，让它变成法律的？答案是 The President。The President 在国会通过这个法案之后，要送给总统。那总统签署之后，才会变成法律。Who signs bills to become laws?The president, the president. 那下一题也很像，34题 ，Who vetoes bills? Who vetoes bills? Vetoes 就是否决的意思，谁能否决国会通过的法案？答案一样是 the president, the president. 刚刚说过。国会通过法案之后会送给总统，总统签下去就变成法律了，但是如果总统不签，就等于是否决了国会通过的法案 vetoes。 那问题我们再念一次， Who vetoes bills? Who vetoes bills? 答案是 The President。 The President。那我们到下一题。What does the president's cabinet do? What does the president's cabinet do? 总统的内阁是做什么的？ President's cabinet 是总统的内阁。看到这里有一个一撇，然后 S， 那就是总统的。President's 总统的，它也是的的意思。那我们再念一次问题 ：What does the president's cabinet do? Cabinet 一般我们知道是有门的柜子，可以把门关起来的柜子。那它在这边是翻成内阁的意思，内阁。那我们再把问题念一次。What does the president's cabinet do? What does the president's cabinet do? Advise the president. Advise the president. Advise 就是建议的意思。所以呢，他们给总统建议，对总统提出建议。那下一题我们会看到更多有关总统内阁的事情。第36题， What are two cabinet level positions? What are two cabinet level positions? 那 cabinet 刚刚讲了是内阁的意思， level 呢就是等级的意思，所以在这个内阁等级的职位，他要你说两个。What are two cabinet level position? 请说出两个内阁部长的职位。 那这里这四个答案呢是最好记的答案，所以大家可以从这里开始记。如果你有记习惯的答案的话也没有关系，就记你的就好了。第一个，国防部长， Secretary of Defense， Secretary of Defense， Defense 是防御的意思。 Secretary of Defense， 国防部长。第二个， Secretary of Labor， Secretary of Labor， Labor 是劳工的意思。 Secretary of Labor， 劳工部长。第三个，Secretary of State， Secretary of State， State 是国务的意思，国家的。 Secretary of State， 国务卿。最后一个， Attorney General， Attorney General， Attorney 呢一般可以用成是说律师或者是法律上的，所以是司法。Attorney General， Attorney General， 司法部长。那这一题我们再复习一次。 What are two cabinet level positions？ What are two cabinet level positions？ 第一个， Secretary of Defense， Secretary of Defense， 国防部长。第二个， Secretary of Labor， Secretary of Labor， 劳工部长。第三个， Secretary of State， Secretary of State， 国务卿。最后一个， Attorney General， Attorney General， 司法部长。那我们到下一题，第37题。 What does the judicial branch do? What does the judicial branch do? 所以我们之前讲到，这个政府有三个部门，其中一个是 judicial branch， 司法部门，另外两个是 executive， 还有一个是 legislature， 那 judicial 就是第三个。那我们来看一下，司法部门是做什么的？ judicial branch 就是司法部门。那我们来看一下他们做什么。第一个， reviews laws， reviews laws， 检讨现有的法律。 explains US laws， explain US laws， 解释美国法律。第三个， resolves disputes， resolves disputes，解决争议。最后一个， decides if a law goes against the Constitution， 决定某一个法律是否抵触宪法。这里只需要讲一个答案，所以您可以挑你喜欢的记起来。那我们再把问题念一次。 What does the judicial branch do? What does the judicial branch do?Do， 第一个 reviews laws， reviews laws， 检讨现有法律。第二个 explains US laws， explains US laws。 那为什么要解释呢？要解释的原因是因为呢，法律上有很多灰色的地带，所以呢，要是双方有不清楚的或是有争执的，对某个法律的解释不一样，他们就会去问法官，或者是他们就会上法庭，然后法庭要做的工作就是解释美国的法律。 Explains US laws。 resolves disputes. Resolves disputes. Resolve 的意思是解决，那 disputes 是争议。Resolves disputes. 最后一个 decides if a law goes against the Constitution. 这句话比较长，那它的意思是说呢 ，decides 是决定，决定看看一个法律是否有抵触宪法，这是抵触的意思。那 the Constitution 我们前面学过，第一题 Constitution 是宪法。那最后我们再念一次 ，What does the judicial branch do? What does the judicial branch do? Reviews laws. Explains U.S. laws. Resolves disputes. Decides if a law goes against the Constitution. Decides if a law goes against the Constitution. 那我们到下一题。第38题。What is the highest court in the United States? What is the highest court in the United States? Highest 就是最高的意思。Court 是法院。美国最高的法院是什么？答案是 the Supreme Court。The Supreme Court 最高法院。 Supreme 这个字我们之前有讲到，我们在说宪法的时候有用到这个字。美国最高的法律是什么？ What is the supreme law of the land? 那 Supreme 就是最高的意思。第38题我们再念一次。 What is the highest courtIn the United States. What is the highest court in the United States? 答案是 the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court. 联邦最高法院。The Supreme Court. 那我们到第39题。我们先念一次问题。How many justices are on the Supreme Court? How many justices are on the Supreme Court? Justices 是大法官，其他的法官叫做 judge. How many justices are on the Supreme Court? 答案是 9, 九位。 9我们再念一次问题。 How many justices are on the Supreme Court? How many justices are on the Supreme Court? 答案是 9. 那我们到第40题，也是我们今天的最后一题，是跟联邦的大法官有关的。 Who is the Chief Justice of the United States? Who is the Chief Justice of the United States? Chief 是首席，我们前面有看到这个字，前面看到的字呢是说 Commander in Chief，三军统帅，最高领导人。那 Chief Justice 一样就是最高的大法官，也就是首席大法官。那他在问谁是现任联邦首席大法官？ Who is the Chief Justice of the United States? 答案是 John Roberts. John Roberts. 第四十题我们再念一次。Who is the Chief Justice of the United States? Who is the Chief Justice of the United States? 答案是 John Roberts。John Roberts。那我们今天的课就到这边结束了。如果你有问题的话，可以在微信上面问我。谢谢大家，希望大家都平平安安的。